Previously on Game of Thrones.
To ensure there's no trouble, Lord Whitehill will install a garrison of 20 men within your walls. You have a man you trust?
My son, Griff.
I suppose the Crown could be persuaded to secure Ironwood from House Forrester. Lady Marjorie might not look favorably on such an alliance. And it would infuriate Cersei. Although what would be amusing for me might prove rather dangerous for you and your house.
Father, I'm going to kill you.
Is that so?
I'm glad I found you, my boy. It's been far too long.
Who the fuck is he?
My uncle.
Roderick?
Roderick!
Oh, the gods, it is you!
Sir?
Fetch the maester, hurry!
Fetch the maester!
Let her go!
Fuck you!
You kill me, and the Lost Legion won't stop until you and your friend are dead.
She's been gone a while.
She'll come back.
If they catch her, they'll kill her.
They won't catch her.
She's costing us time. It's just that we need to get to Meereen. Every day we lose here is a day that Talia or Ryan could be hurt, or worse. You must return home safely, Asher, and... Well, you have a history of putting your faith in women who may not deserve it.
Uncle. Was it them? The Lost Legion?
Aye. Too many for us to take. I counted about 24, maybe more, as well as horses. About half a mile down the canyon, and coming fast. Had to run my arse off to avoid getting caught. It's nearly empty. You two care if I finish it off?
It might be a while before we find more water.
I'm dying, though.
Nah. Drink up.
Thanks.
Right. We need to get moving.
The Lost Legion. We're 100 miles from Yunkai. When are they going to give up?
Never. They're still raw about T'Zaal.
Yes, well, perhaps you shouldn't have snapped his neck. There is such a thing as overdoing. Not that I care about T'Zaal.
He was gutter trash, and I bloody felt like it. That neck was begging to get stomped.
You've grown older, but you haven't grown up.
It's only a matter of time before they overtake us. Ah, bugger a harpy.
Can we double back?
Not without meeting our mates from Yunkai. We're well and truly fucked this time, Asher.
During severe winters, when the Skahazadan floods, it carves out great underground rivers in the sandstone.
And
when those waters recede, those rivers become caves. And those caves might hide us, if we can find them. I mean, we're trapped for the moment, but all I'm saying is we needn't die here, just standing our ground.
Let's spread out and look for cover.
If he's right about this, I may actually stab him. It's not gonna happen. It's too unstable.
You found anything?
Not yet. What's on your mind?
We all need to pull together if we're going to get out of this and onto Marine. I can't have you and Beska scrapping.
So much riding on this. Talia, Ryan, your mother. You and I are supposed to return to Westeros with a sellsword army, and I haven't the faintest idea how we're going to pull it off. So, if I seem a bit moody, that's why.
You see? Beska came back. She risked her life out there, for us. You trust her now?
This may sound harsh, but Beska's immaterial. I have to put you first. You are all that matters to me, Asher.
Beska matters to me. How do you know all that? About the floods and the caves?
I read all about Essos on the voyage over. Histories of Marine, histories of Slaver's Bay. I just hope it pays off.
Let me know if you find anything. What do you think? Could we climb out of here?
Pretty steep, Asher.
And we'd be totally exposed if your friends arrived before we reached the top.
Looks like we're not alone. No obvious wounds. Maybe he died of thirst. Listen. That's water. I hear water.
From underground. There might be a cave nearby. Well, we can't stay here.
I think I see a light in there.
A way through.
Oh, we couldn't be that lucky. Shit. It's them.
Ponte Freedom! Che si rizzi!
Shit! Come on! Go, go, go! Right behind us! Damn it!
Asha! Find us another way out of here!
Got it! What in seven hells is that? I can't even guess what this used to be.
There's a light!
Go! See if there's a way through!
We'll hold them off!
Yeah!
down!
Malcolm! Can you walk?
I'm fine. I've fought wars with worse than this.
Hurry! The beast is coming around!
Asha!
Grab my hand!
Hurry, Asha! It's nearly on you!
Listen up, you sorry lot. Gather round. We're handing out assignments today.
Garrett, we'll be men of the watch before nightfall.
Right. Sorry. No hard feelings over that business with Finn, yeah? I appreciate you not ratting me out over the knife. It's nice to know there's at least one brother I can trust.
Just promise me you'll stop stealing things, Cutter.
All right. I swear it. Never again. Well, no guarantees on potatoes or lamprey pie. Or for that matter. Just messing with you, Garrett. I promise. I'll mend my thieving ways.
Well, aren't you two sons of whores looking thick as thieves? Having a good laugh over nicking my knife, eh, Garrett? Men like you turn traitor for nothing. It's in your blood. Next, you'll be killing men of the watch for a loaf of bread. Aye. You're worse than Cotter. At least he has the guts to do the deed himself. You'll always be an asshole, Garrett. You're just a fucking craven.
I will never call you my brother, Finn.
I wouldn't fucking want you to.
Finn, leave him alone. It wasn't Garrett's fault. If you're gonna hate someone, hate me.
With pleasure.
Now, it doesn't matter what the world once called you. After today, you're all brothers. Could even be that the man standing next to you saves your life one day. Or maybe you'll save his.
Let's find out then, shall we?
Casper, to the builders. Finn, to the rangers. Eric, to the stewards. Hugh, to the rangers. Cotter, to the builders! And finally, Garrett to the rangers. That's it. May all the gods preserve you.
Well, there we are. I'll be patching up the wall, and you'll be defending it.
Should you northern boys want your gods to give a blessing to this union, there's a weirwood tree beyond the wall. Now form up and follow my lead.
Garrod, it's good to hear you'll be a ranger.
Thank you.
I know you wanted this.
I'm ready to say my vows.
I didn't have many friends when I first arrived at Castle Black. Grin and Pip, they'd as sooner see me bloodied in the yard than offer a hand. Now, I'd die for either of them. Our brothers are all we have.
Finn.
Shows you what kind of ripe fools are running this place. I can't believe they made you a ranger. You're not fit for the job. You don't have any balls between your legs.
It's not your concern, Finn.
That's where you're wrong. I need to know if I'll be fighting alongside a thief.
I didn't steal your knife.
You wouldn't even be here if you didn't have Snow leading you by the hand the whole way.
Well, people might help you if you weren't such an asshole, Finn.
I wouldn't have to be if you all weren't assholes too. No one around here gives a shit about me. They wouldn't even care if I... Do you know how many rangers are never heard from again in these parts? And I'm about to become one myself. All alone out here. Wildlings everywhere.
Finn, don't worry. You were born to kill wildlings. When I punched you the other day, most men would have gone down like a sack of potatoes. But you gave it right back to me.
I suppose you're right.
You want a different assignment, because I hear they need someone to clean the shithouse.
See, that's why I got so fucking mad at you, Garrett. You're the closest thing I have to a friend.
You handled that well, Garrett. They say the old gods watch us through the weirwoods. More than watch us. They know us. The gods are not forgiving. We brothers have to be. We're here. After this, there's no going back. Now go. Take your vows.
In the eyes of the old gods, the Night's Watch offers you a place beside us. Now say the words for all to hear and embrace us as your own.
Hear my words, and bear witness to my vow. Night gathers, and now my watch begins.
It shall not end until my death. I shall take no wife, hold no lands, father no children. I shall wear no crowns, and win no glory. I shall live. And die at my post. I am the sword in the darkness. I am the watcher on the walls. I am the shield that guards the realms of men. I pledge my life and honor to the Night's Watch for this night and all the nights to come.
You knelt as boys. Rise now as men of the Night's Watch.
Welcome to your new family, Garrett.
We're men of the watch now. Means we get to piss off the wall whenever we want.
Didn't know you needed an excuse to play with yourself, Finn.
Garrett, you've got a visitor. Over there.
Well, who is it?
Do I look like your fucking squire?
Don't forget the practice shorts.
Uncle Duncan!
Garrett! It's good to see you. They told me you were at the Weirwood Tree. Wasn't sure you'd be back in time.
I've missed you, Uncle. I never expected to see you here.
I've business with the Night's Watch. A delivery of Ironwood shields to keep you all out of harm's way. That settles it, then?
Aye, the delivery looks in order.
The gods do grant miracles. You look well, nephew. I'm told you're a ranger now. That's good.
Uncle?
Things aren't going well at Ironwrath, Garrett.
I know. I heard the news about Ethan.
I wasn't there when it happened. Small mercy, I suppose. Not having to see our lord struck down with such barbarity. But House Forrester is nothing, if not resilient. Our house has survived for centuries.
Let me help, Uncle. I can't just sit here at the wall while our enemies are circling Ironwrath.
That's why I'm really here. Do you recall Lord Forrester's last words to you? Just before he died, Gregor's final command, spoken to you in confidence.
He said the North Grove must never be lost.
Indeed. But first, it must be found. I've been reading his journals, scouring the legends for any clue what Lord Forrester knew. I think I've found the answer. He describes a fortification, a protected citadel of sorts, hidden from the world, one filled with great power. It was scattered among his notes. Almost an obsession.
What do you think, Uncle? Is it real?
I have no doubt. It's clear Lord Forrester spent a great deal of time studying the North Grove. He speaks of it as if he'd seen it himself. Somewhere on the other side of the wall. And you must find it, Garrett. The search won't be easy. But you're a Tuttle. Our lord knew you wouldn't fail him.
It can't be too hard to get north of the wall. I'm sure there's a way.
As a ranger, that shouldn't be a problem.
How am I supposed to find it?
The first chance you get to head north, take it.
And then?
You leave the Night's Watch behind and strike out on your own. This is no small request I make. I know that. But there's no other choice.
Uncle, that's desertion. The Night's Watch execute men who desert.
I know. I wouldn't ask this of you if there was another way. This will help guide you. I found it hidden in Lord Forrester's strongbox.
What is that?
A page from our lord's journal. But one he tore out and kept separate. Why? I don't know.
It's a map. To the North Grove.
Aye.
This looks familiar.
What is it, Garrett?
Talia gave me this. Before I left.
Oh. Wait. Lord Forrester gave Ethan a similar one as well. Roderick too. I wonder.
You said it was a citadel of some kind. Could this be it? No. No, it couldn't be that easy. It's hidden here somewhere. I used to be frightened of Weirwood Trees. Well, before I was a man grown. I swear, I actually could hear them whispering sometimes. Hear the Weirwoods whisper. Bloody ice dragon. Gods be good. Now that I would love to see. A mammoth? This map's only missing grumpkins and snarks. This can't be real, Uncle. Look. There's a clasp.
It must open.
I had no idea this was inside. Another weirwood.
But why?
Maybe it's a key to solving the map. A perfect fit. Maybe it's telling us where to look on the map. Oh, it's the whole map that has to turn.
Aye.
The Werewood's mouth. Uncle, whatever this place is, the North Grove must be near.
There's only one way to find out. Here, take this map. Everything we hold dear may well depend on your success. It's a lot to put on your shoulders. The lives of a whole house.
Uncle, I can't break my vows. I can't do it.
I understand your reluctance. When you left Ironrath, you said you'd serve with honor. You already have. God's watch over you. You're the son I never had.
Let's go, Garrett.
I don't know. They're probably like little shards.
I hope to never lift one of those again.
Wait, so, like a weapon?
Well, your piss is like any other liquid, I reckon.
Yeah, mine's mostly ale.
And if it froze on the way down the wall?
Well, that was rather mysterious. A stranger arrives and you're chatting him up.
Someone said it was your uncle looking for you. Well, what did he want?
Looked like you two had a lot to talk about.
Must have been important to come to Castle Black.
He happened to be nearby. Thought he'd say hello.
This is about the last place anyone would want to visit.
It looked like he gave you something.
It was nothing. Let's go and celebrate.
Already keeping secrets from your brothers, eh?
Garrett's right. The wall's gonna melt before we get up there. Come on.
There are so many guests already arriving. And have you seen the wedding decorations they put up in the gardens? So beautiful. You know, we're as lucky as she is. Marjorie was but a lady when we were sent to serve at Highgarden. But in just a few days' time, we'll be attending to a queen at a royal feast. Where we're standing, we'll be able to see everyone. And everyone will be able to see us.
Sarah, it will be Marjorie's day, not ours.
I know. I didn't mean anything by it. I've been meaning to say what I told you about my family. It means a lot to be able to share that with someone. Someone I can trust.
Sarah, you should be careful who you trust around here. Secrets can be dangerous in the wrong hands.
I'll certainly be more careful in the future. Hold on, look. There he is.
Lord Morgrin?
No, next to him. Lord Tarwick. I don't want to be a handmaiden forever. And this wedding may be the best chance of meeting a husband I'll ever have. I have to go talk to him. Marjorie won't notice it for a few minutes longer.
Could you
Make an excuse for me? Please. I'm not asking for much.
Are you sure you know what you're doing, Sarah?
Marjorie's so busy. I can't just wait for her to find a match for me. Please, just don't tell Marjorie.
What are you doing here?
Oh no, I shouldn't be here. But we have to talk. I didn't know when I would see you next. I couldn't risk waiting. I needed to warn you. I was down in Fleabottom last night when I overheard a couple of Lannister guards talking about...
Shh!
They already know he's missing, probably dead. They're questioning people, searching for his body. He's not safe for either of us.
Who are they questioning? Do they know about me?
I don't think so. But why would they have any reason to? Anyway, he'll never show up again to tell them. No one will know what you did. What? What is it? If we're gonna survive this, there can't be any details we've overlooked.
I still have his knife.
Oh, no. Just keep it hidden and clean the blood off it. Meantime, just stay out of sight.
How? Do you forget who I serve?
Just don't get in any more trouble. And I'll watch your back. We're in this together now.
Why are you helping me?
What do you mean? I'm a friend, Lady Mira. My name's Tom. We help each other, or it's both our heads.
What were you even doing there that night?
I once told you, there are people who'd be willing to help you. People who want you alive. I'm here to make sure that happens.
Wait, what? You mean someone...
Mira?
My lady...
Really? A tryst in the bushes with that coal boy? Not to say it's wrong, but with all the lords and knights in King's Landing, you just don't want to spoil your chances of a good marriage.
Can we just keep it between us? I prefer nobody knows.
We'll keep each other's secrets. That's what friends do. Come on. Marjorie expects us at the throne room. We don't want to be late.
You can tell me all about this Lord Tarwick on the way.
Well, if you really want to know. First of all, his name's Garibald, and he has this really funny accent. He told me the cleverest story about this festival they have where they celebrate...
And I've given the musicians a list of songs to play for Joffrey at the feast. I assume you have no problems with the Reigns of Castamere?
I trust you've chosen all the standards. But just to be sure, I'll draw up a list of wedding ballads we favor in Highgarden.
Your Grace. My lady.
Which reminds me, Joffrey will require his Kingsguard close at hand during the feast. I'm afraid we'll have no room for your handmaidens.
But we...
What was that? Do you object? Is that what I heard? If you're going
Your
to
Grace,
speak out of turn, girl...
I...
You should finish what you start.
There is simply an awe of your presence, Your Grace. We're happy to spend the feast wherever it pleases you.
Your happiness is not my concern. I asked your handmaiden here at the Iron Throne whom she would serve if forced to choose between yourself and the king. She was deferential to the crown then, as she is now. But words are wind. In any case, it's settled. The Kingsguard will stay with Joffrey. Your handmaidens will sit elsewhere.
Of course, Your Grace. Anything for my beloved Joffrey.
Lady Marjorie, we may not see eye to eye on everything, But I hope you will at least agree with me that our handmaidens should know their place. And that place is not with my brother, Tyrion.
What did she mean by that? You and Tyrion? What you do reflects on me. If something's going on, I need to know about it.
I haven't done anything wrong, my lady.
That's not how it seemed. Queen Cersei made it seem like much more than that. Sarah, what do you know of this?
Mira would never go against your wishes, my lady.
What am I to think, Mira? I've only ever tried to help you. Why are you making trouble for me?
The Queen was just trying to upset you. There's nothing to tell.
I don't have the time or patience for your games, Mira. Right now, I need you both to be my handmaidens, and that's all I need you to be. Let there be no mistake. If I hear of you speaking so much as a word to Tyrion Lannister again, you can go home to your family.
I'm sorry, my lady. I made a mistake. It won't happen again. Please, don't send me home.
This can't happen again.
Roderick, it's the White Hills. They're assembling in the courtyard. They've woken the house. You can't let this go on. They want to see us cower in our own house.
Don't worry, Tally. I'll deal with them.
Hurry, I'll check on Mother. What is this?
It's a parade of dead men if I have my way. Who's behind this? Come out and face me!
Those are strong words. For a cripple who can't carry a sword.
All of you, show your respect to Griff Whitehill, fourth-born son of Lord Lud Whitehill and commander of this garrison.
Cocky Roderick, we used to call you. Swinging your prick round, lording it over my family. Now look at you, eh?
Roderick the Ruined.
I hardly recognize you. But the name fits, don't it? Pathetic.
I've had enough of this, Griff. What are you trying to prove here?
I had to get your attention, didn't I? Always so busy beating your own chest, Roderick. I don't think he gets it.
No, my lord. I don't think he does.
Your brother Ethan didn't get it either.
You bite your tongue.
I am in charge now. And the first thing you need to know is that if I am not happy, no one is happy. So my men are taking over your great hall. That's where we'll quarter from now on.
What? You can't.
You'll have to go through me.
I won't have my men sleeping out in your barn in shit and filth. Maybe that's how foresters live, but not us.
If I allow you in my hall, will that secure the peace?
I wasn't fucking asking, Roderick. And what's more, you will treat my men right. I've heard what you've done, and if they're eating wormy bread, then your people better be eating shit off the ground.
I'm not here to keep them in line. I'm here to keep you in line. You think you're being clever?
If your men don't like it here, you can march them back to High Point.
Watch yourself, Roderick.
This is against the King's law. You've no right to make such demands.
I have every right. We're here under the orders of Roose Bolton, Warden of the North. So I will be in your halls. I will be in your courtyard. I will sit on your fucking council and be in your bedchambers if I bloody well please.
You can't do this,
little bastard. You can't just do whatever...
We'll do what we were sent here to do.
You're mad, Griff. This is my house and you will do as I say.
Why should I listen to some cripple with half a face? Now, me and my men will take our place in your hall. Unless you think you and your army can stop me. No, you know better than that. You know where we'll be.
This is outrageous.
Roderick!
You can't go in there.
We can and we will. Unless you want this all to end right now, eh? I'm the only lord here.
Come on.
Griff Whitehill, a snot-nosed fourthborn, parading in here like a conquering fucking hero.
It was bad enough when it was just the soldiers.
We can't live with them under our roof, soiling our house.
I know you tried to stop them, my lord. But we can only take this occupation for so long. Our people will break, and the way Griff Whitehill came in...
Whether he rides out on horseback, or ends up in the ground, Griff Whitehill won't be here long. I'll see to it.
Very good, my lord.
But Griff Whitehill isn't the beginning of our troubles, or the end of them. We need to look at all the pieces. Whitehill men aren't just in our house. They've raided our lands, burnt farms and cut down our trees. All the way from here to High Point.
How do we kill a snake then? By smashing its head.
Griff is in the head. It's his father.
Perhaps. But Griff is here. We have access to him.
And they have Ryan. He carved these soldiers himself. I don't care what Gwyn Whitehill may have told you at the funeral. Who knows what horrors they're putting him through, held prisoner at High Point. You can't forsake his safety.
But we have to do something. My lord, at least give us a target to aim for.
We have to push Griff and his soldiers out of Ironwrath. They're the most immediate threat.
But Roderick, what of Ryan? If you move against Griff, who knows what those wretches will do to my son?
Knowing the Whitehills, they'd gut him and leave him at our gates.
If we do nothing, we are dead on our feet. Our enemies are not just at our gates. They are within them. We must secure Ironwrath, so we have a home to bring Ryan back to.
Don't forget him.
Then... it's decided. We take back our home.
We lost most of our men with Gregor at the Twins.
We can probably gather another 30 or 40 men.
But the Whitehills are already fortified inside Ironwrath.
Unfortunately, Roderick was not able to secure the backing of the Glenmores. That means we have to count on Asha and Myrra.
How?
Asha means to sail home from Essos with a company of hardened sellswords. But they're not bannermen. We'll need to pay them for it. Which is why Myrra's part to play is just as crucial. She can get us the coin we need in King's Landing.
You don't imagine we have the luxury of waiting for them. Asha and Mira are a long way from here.
I have faith in my children.
I don't think Lud Whitehall will kindly stand by while we pull ourselves together.
If we have to go to battle before we're ready, we risk losing everything. But sometimes you have no choice.
That time may indeed come, but it's not now. The White Hills aren't ready for war.
It won't be long before you're able to take action yourself.
Well, one way or another, there's a fight brewing, so I have much to prepare, and men to train.
My lord?
My lord, there may be something we can do now.
A voice from High Point, Gwyn Whitehill.
I spoke with her at the funeral.
As did I, and she's willing to meet. Away from her father's guards. I may not be your sentinel, but please consider this. It would be wise to hear what she has to say.
Do you think she can be trusted?
It's possible she has other motives, but it's a chance to learn more about our enemies. We need to take it, and I'll make sure no one else knows. For now, at least.
Good.
Handle things right with Gwyn, and she may even help us in High Point, when the time comes.
I want the dove pie served with a spoon of lemon cream. We'll have to let the kitchens know. And these flowers. They're just all wrong in the Crownlands. Mira, are you listening to me?
Lady Marjorie, good tidings to you today.
Thank you, Lord Tyrion.
And you, Lady Mira, a word in private, if I may. I'll return her shortly.
Who would I be to deny Lord Tyrion?
Very soon you'll be the Queen. And if you're anything like the current one, you'll deny me all you like.
Please excuse me for a moment, my lady.
I promise I won't keep you long. I don't think Lady Marjorie likes me. Although, after tonight, I suspect I won't be her least favorite Lannister anymore.
What did you want, my lord?
Oh, there's much unpleasant business to be done today. But I bring you a bit of good news. I've arranged for the Crown to purchase Forrester Ironwood. A royal decree sits on my desk now, and I'll have my squire Podrick see to it at the first opportunity. You'll bring prosperity to your family. They're lucky to have you.
You honor me, Lord Tyrion. Only you could make such a strong gesture to House Forrester. My lord, do I still owe you a favor?
As handmaiden to the new queen, you will undoubtedly prove useful. I'm sure I'll think of something. Enjoy the festivities.
Goodbye, Lord Tyrion.
Today of all days, you know I didn't want you talking to him. You're playing a dangerous game, Mira. Sarah will help me with my gown and hair.
But
I'll deal with you after the wedding. Come with me, Sarah.
Garrett.
Easy now.
Sorry. I was just keeping at the ready.
That's good. Don't lose that. I understand your uncle paid you a visit. What did he want? Not many people pass through here. What brought him this far?
He was just delivering ironwood shields for the Night's Watch.
Good. Our stocks are running low. I know it couldn't be easy seeing him, but you have to leave all that behind. Especially now that you're a ranger.
Aye.
I know you had told me you could stand with these men, but not every brother's a friend, if it came to it. And you were in trouble north of the wall. Any of them you'd trust by your side?
You know these men. Who do you want watching your back?
Finn can handle himself. I'd bring him to a fight.
I'm glad you can trust your brother. I'll remember him.
Erolt Holt of White Harbor, Corliss Wells from Stony Sept. And finally, we've got more spawn of nobility joining us.
No.
Brit Warwick of House Whitehill.
It can't be.
House Whitehill. Make sure you're not bringing this one to the Boltons.
There'll be a hot meal in the mess hall. After that, we'll be sorting out gear at the armory.
Garrett.
We'll be practice swords to
Garrett,
start.
What's the matter?
Don't want anyone.
You know him.
Come on, get moving.
Garrett, who is he?
That man murdered my family.
What?
Snow! See these new recruits to the Maester.
Don't do something you regret.
If it isn't the fucking pig farmer. I'm here because of you. Got sent to the wall for that little party I do with your family. Don't think it's over. Best watch your back.
What are you waiting for, recruit? Personal invitation from the king?
I got nothing to say to you. Now get out my sight.
And will you make me?
That's enough, both of you. I said move.
I'll be seeing you, farm boy.
This isn't fair. We were supposed to be up there. I'll never see another wedding like this. I don't know what you did with Tyrion Lannister that made Cersei want to punish you, but it never should have affected me like this.
I'm so sorry. I had no idea any of this would happen. But what Tyrion Lannister did for me, it may have saved my family.
I hope that's true, Mira. I really do. Because you don't know how furious Margaery is at you. When I was getting her dressed for the wedding, she was talking about who she could replace you with. I probably shouldn't have even told you. But I suppose you have a right to know.
Tell me who it is.
Why? What are you going to do to her?
Sarah?
It doesn't matter. It was just names. This is about you. Look, you once promised to help me with Margaery when our positions were reversed. That meant everything to me. Maybe now I'm in a position to help you. Otherwise, Margaery's going to make you leave King's Landing. You're pushing her to it, Mira.
Thank you, Sarah. I could really use a hand right now. I don't want to do this all alone.
Don't worry. We'll figure this out. I'll beg Margaery if I have to. I'm not letting her send you home.
Already serving the pie.
Oi!
We're missing everything.
I know you. You were in the gardens the other night with Damien. Before he disappeared. I have a few questions to ask you. What were you doing there with him?
Mira?
Don't think I don't know it was you.
So what if I was with him?
No! Seven hells.
You there, girl. I need a towel or a wet cloth, something.
Lord Morgren.
You'll need to find someone else. I'm not finished
with
her.
Are you sick, man? You think I have time to bother with handmaidens? Release her or I'll have Queen Cersei find you another job. Well, I just ruined a perfectly good shirt to come to your rescue. No need to explain what that was all about. We all have our own mischief to hide.
That was kind of you. I do appreciate it.
Well, I didn't do it merely for your benefit.
Then
Why?
Perhaps I recognize a kindred spirit. It's not every little handmaiden who can steal an ironwood decree with the crown right out from under my nose. Consider me impressed. My partners, I'm afraid to say, felt rather differently about it.
So what does that make you, if a little handmaiden could steal your very important deal?
Aren't you the tart one? I'm a man who knows when to recognize a fixed game. The question is, can you? Do you even understand why Tyrion gave you the ironwood deal? Because it wasn't out of the kindness of his heart.
I'm no fool. He wants something from me. Access to Margaery. Or perhaps he just knew he could get the cheapest ironwood from me.
Very observant. You are no mere handmaiden. I remember what it was like to be new to this game. You feel like you're drowning, don't you? But there's no one you can really trust. What you need more than anything is an ally. I could be that for you, Lady Mira. Is that something you'd be interested in?
And what exactly are the terms of this offer? What do you get out of it?
A smart question. So, let me be blunt. Circumstances have put us at odds. But what if we were to work together? Control the price of ironwood together? We could get very, very rich together. Or should I go back to Lord Whitehill, who has proven to be very interested in it?
Don't touch him! Take him!
What happened? Joffrey's dead!
I'm afraid it just became a very bad time to be linked to Tyrion Lannister. Tell me that you got that ironwood decree from him before the wedding.
Oh no. He said it was waiting for me on his desk.
What a shame. Such potential. I'm afraid any chance of our alliance has become quite impossible. You understand, Lady Mira.
Can you help me get it out?
I have my own affairs to deal with. But if it were to disappear, perhaps we could talk again. You have a good head for business, Lady Mira. It'd be terribly disappointing to see it on the end of a pike.
Not getting in this way.
Tom!
What in seven hells do you think you're doing up here? What are you thinking? You've got to leave. Now.
Tom, I'm in trouble. There's something inside I need to get. If I don't, it's going to be a nightmare.
Damn it. Whatever trouble you're in could be trouble for me too.
So what do we do?
I have an idea. The terrace.
The what?
I could maybe climb across the roof and drop down onto the outside terrace. It's just... I don't know, Mira. Is whatever's in there really worth risking my life for? It's not just kings who die stupidly around here.
Tom, I really need your help here. I can't do this alone. Just be careful.
Wait here. I'll be at the door before you know it.
Just what do you think you're doing here? You shouldn't be anywhere near this place.
I work for Lady Margaery. Queen Margaery, She asked me to wait here.
Somehow I find that hard to believe. I'm not going to ask you again.
Oi! Whoever's in there, I command you to open this door at once, in the name of the king! You! Don't move!
Tom! It's me! Hurry!
Gods, that was close. I almost didn't make it back down here. Some tiles on the roof came loose. Almost lost my footing.
Tom, we have to hurry. I'm looking for a piece of paper. A royal decree.
Well, go on. That Lannister guard could be back with help any second. I'll keep watch outside the door.
Tom!
You can do this.
He said that it would be on his desk. It's the bill for the wedding. This is more money than I could spend in a lifetime. Oh, nothing. Just a letter from Tywin Lannister. Tyrion's strongbox. Oh, it must be in here.
Mira, I think the Lannister guard is back.
No, it's the other one.
Damn it, hide! I find a way to distract them.
I'm telling you, I heard someone in here.
Search the place. We'll find them.
And after? Now that we've got the imp's keys, we can have a little look inside his lockboxes, eh?
Aye.
Help! Fire!
What the hell? Damn it! Come on!
You did it. How?
I lit a tapestry on fire down the hall. I'll watch you a minute, maybe two.
Oh, thank you.
Did you find it?
Oh, I think it has to be in here. Oh, it has to be. Oh!
Come on!
No.
Just hurry! Finally, let's go.
If I catch the bastard who...
Oh, wring their bloody neck.
We're not far now. Gwyn Whitehill may already be there.
What is this? Our ironwood trees. It's the White Hills. You see what they've done? This track was hundreds of years old.
It's all gone. There's nothing but stumps.
The White Hills need to answer for this. And Gwyn needs to answer for this. But we need to find out what she knows. She'll be over there. Be cautious, Milan. If she go around her father to help us, she must have some purpose. Just be wary, my lord. You see what her family's done here. Here. You might want this. You may have known each other since you were children, but this could be a trap.
Doesn't hurt to be careful.
Go on. I'll stay with the horses.
This is old Red Rob's farm. Used to play here when I was young. What's happened to them?
It's not enough to take our wood. They must defile our homes.
Damned White Hills. Cutting down everything they see. Do they understand nothing about ironwood? Split beams, cracked wheels, shoddy workmanship. Clearly White Hill. This well. I remember hiding down there, playing monsters and maidens with little Naaman and Megan. I can still smell the sawdust. Hear the whining of the grindstone. Such a part of my early years. So long ago.
I see you haven't lost your warrior's ways. That's good. I wouldn't want to deal with someone careless.
Hello, Gwyn.
Roderick. You saw my father's work over there, didn't you? There's no way to miss it.
And he won't stop. He means to do that to every inch of your land.
Damn your father. He's laid waste to this land. My land. I'll have my vengeance for this.
I brought you here so that you would see what's happening. So there's no need to make threats against my father. I come as a friend.
Do you?
Yes, I do. I wasn't sure you were even going to show. We're taking a risk, meeting like this.
Thank you for paying respects to my father and brother. And for coming tonight. It's good to see you again.
And you too, Roderick. I think we can help each other. But first, I've heard news of Asher. That he plans to return to Ironwrath. Why is he coming back? I loved him once. I longed for Asher to come back. But not like this.
If you must know, he's bringing us an army.
You may think that's going to help your family. But it will only lead to more killing. I want peace between our families. No more wars. No more bloodshed. Is that what you want to? I need to hear you say it, Roderick. Will you work with me to bring an end to this war?
I want to know the price before I agree to pay it. I'm no fool.
It seems that you are, because you clearly don't understand. Peace is the only hope your family has. My father is just waiting for an excuse to attack. Why do you think he sent my brother? So there will be trouble. My father will bring utter ruin on your house. Unless... you let Griff feel like he's in control. I know you refuse to kiss my father's ring, but you would be wise to show more respect to Griff.
I'm not afraid of some petulant fourthborn.
You should be, because there's a very dangerous fourthborn in your house right now.
My lord, a band of riders approach from the north.
Seven hells. My father's guards must be tracking me. If they catch us here, they'll kill you.
I'll face them if I must.
You should be smarter than that. Just listen. My father is planning to make a move against your family. I don't know all the details, but he's been sending a great deal of gold to someone in King's Landing. I fear for your family, Roderick. You may think you've nothing more to lose. He is ready to show you otherwise.
What the hell is your father planning?
I swear I don't know, but whatever it is... he knows all your weaknesses, all your plans.
What? How?
Because you have a traitor in your council.
Someone who knows every detail of your circumstances.
You must tell me. Who is it?
I don't know. We know you're planning to force Griff from your home, even if it endangers Ryan's life.
What?
My father's guards are close. I need to know you'll do what I've asked. Promise me you'll submit to Griff. If you want peace between our families, it's the only way.
You have my word, Gwyn. I'll do my part.
Thank you.
My lord, those riders are nearly upon us. We have to go.
What I told you. Be careful what you do with it. And remember, I'll hear about it if you don't.
My lord!
Come along, Duncan. Mother.
Roderick. Look at what's become of our house. You were nowhere to be found, and they just... Oh, they are vile men. Where were you? We need you here. To hold this house together.
Mother, I went to see Gwyn Whitehill.
You did what? You would meet with the girl who once tore this house apart. Oh, I see now why you went in secret. Surely you must have known I would have counseled against it.
She wants to help us. She wants to bring about peace. And as much as you may mistrust her, we need help.
I don't know how you can trust that. Well, what did she have to say?
Lord Whitehill is plotting against us. I don't know his plans. I fear them. And the only way he'll stop is if we submit to Griff's rule of our house.
What? Would you really give up control of our house? Griff is already a torment. How much worse could it get?
Gwyn Whitehill told me I must, if I want to keep the peace.
I don't know how you can trust that.
I don't like it either.
Was this all? Did you learn anything more? You need to tell me. Enough with the mysteries, my son.
What I've told you is nothing compared to what else I've learned. There is a traitor in our house, on our council.
No, this can't be. And all our plans to save Ryan, to save this house.
All gone.
Roderick, who could have turned on us? Times have been hard, but I never thought this would happen. Not in our house.
I don't know. There's no way to be sure.
If we don't know, then we can't trust anyone. Then again, I don't know why we should believe anything that girl told you. The Whitehills would love to sow dissent in our house with lies of traitors.
Get in there! Go and get in there.
What do you want from me?
No, he was over there.
And Ramsay was here.
I'll play it how I want.
You will bend the knee to your liege lord.
Never. I don't kneel to bastards.
Yes, that's so much more fun. Now, give me a wood, boy.
Oh, I heard tales of your cruelty, Lord Ramsay.
Shut your mouths and stop this at once.
Oh, look here. It's the new lord. You're in luck. We're just getting to the best part. Little Lord Ethan's final breath. Unless you want to play the Lord of House Forrester instead.
You can't do this. You can't do this. Get out of our house right now.
We'll do as we please. Besides, we're not finished.
You must stop.
I know you've seen it before, but it gets better every time.
Show some respect in my house, in my home.
And that's what we're doing. Remembering young Ethan as he was.
Oh, please, no!
Say hello to your father.
Oh, no, Ethan!
Sound.
Oh, well done, well done. I'd say he died better than the real Ethan.
Better than the real Ethan.
What about you, eh? You want to be next?
Men without honor are lower than dogs.
I'd be happy to dirty my blade with your blood.
What? All right, who's next?
Make his mother watch.
Now we'll really have some fun.
Enough! Griff will deal with him. When he's done, he'll own this fucking house. And you'll regret what you've done here. Take your boy out of here while you still can.
Roderick! Roderick! Now is not the time.
Wendell, pack the extra rations. Duff, make sure the quivers are full and the torches are dry.
Garrett.
What's happening?
We're heading north of the wall to deliver justice to brothers turned traitor. They're hiding in the woods at a place called Craster's Keep. I've been looking for volunteers.
The cowards murdered Commander Mormon. We're going to kill every one of them.
How far north is this Craster's?
Some 60 miles into Wildling territory. It's treacherous country. I appreciate if you're thinking of going, but you should know Britt volunteered. He took his vows in the sect. He's a brother now. I understand why you hate him. But bad blood could jeopardize this mission. Too many unknowns out there. I can't have my own men killing each other.
I'll go in his place. I'm a better fighter than Britt. You'll want my sword before his.
I don't doubt your skill. But I need every sword that's willing to go. Even someone like Britt. If you do come, I need to know there won't be any trouble. Even if he provokes you.
Can I count on you? I need your word, Garrett. I'll be taking a chance. The mission can't fail.
I'm a man of my word. I won't disappoint you.
I'll hold you to that. It's a hard road to Craster's. We leave tomorrow at first light.
Now why don't you go talk to those two? They volunteered as well. Make sure they're ready. Duff! Where are my arrows?
Well, what did Jon Snow say? I don't think he likes us much.
Definitely doesn't like you, Finn.
Haven't heard him singing your praises any.
He wants us ready for the march tomorrow.
Just give the word. Tired of being under Frostfinger's boot all the time.
You do know we're heading off to fight a band of murderers, right?
That's why you bring a ranger.
Point is, he doesn't want any problems with you going to Craster's.
Well, there's something you should know, then. I borrow this from you.
What?
I just got curious.
I wanted to know why your uncle was here.
It never ends with you.
I didn't mean no harm, honest.
I just wanted a quick look.
I wasn't stealing. Always planned on giving it back.
That's mine. Hand it back.
Of course. I wasn't stealing. I was just taking a peek. But the thing is, I noticed this part here.
North Grove. That's just some shit story for little kids. A rumour.
No, it's not.
Of course it is. I heard it's a witch's den where they turn children into giants. Garrett, you don't actually take it seriously, do you? It's a fairy tale. For idiots. Everyone knows that. Didn't think you were that gullible.
Lord Forrester knew all about it. He said it's a place of great power. Power that could save my house.
And this says it's somewhere in the north. On the other side of the wall.
And here I thought you might have some brains, Garrett. But you deserve each other. Have fun chasing your tails.
Good. Didn't need him anyway.
What do you mean?
Finn doesn't know about the mammoths. Or White Walkers. Or how to sneak past a giant.
What, and you do?
But you know, it's the things you hear about. The rumours is all. I wouldn't know myself. How could I?
Where'd you hear these rumours?
Well, you know, I can't really remember. I hear things around Castle Black. People talk.
Not about the North Grove, they don't.
You do? Probably heard you talking about it. Or maybe one of the recruits. I don't know. It doesn't matter. It was nothing.
Don't make me regret lying about the knife for you, Cotter. Tell me what you know.
All right. I've been on the other side of the wall, Garrett. You see, I live there. In the north. I'm part of the free folk. People round here call wildlings. I know, it's crazy. I was with some other free folk. We were looking for weapons, south of the wall. We got caught. So I passed myself off as a local and, well, they sentenced me here to Castle Black for stealing. I shouldn't be here. This isn't my place. I didn't know what else to do.
Cotter, you're the bloody enemy. How am I supposed to trust you now?
Your enemy, Garrett. I'm your friend. Or at least I thought I was. Are we still friends? I mean, I know it's a lot to take in.
Don't worry. Bloodthirsty wildling or not, we're still brothers.
That is good to hear. At least when Mance Raider wants to boil you alive, you'll know someone in high places.
Cotter! What did I say? That shithouse you fixed is still leaking.
I'll be right there. I'm going back home, no matter what, Garrett. I've heard stories. Old tales of a secret forest within a forest. Your lord knew what he was talking about.
You know where the North Grove is?
No, but I'll help you find it. I'm deserting anyway, heading back home. I can guide you, keep you alive. Stick with me and I'll show you the way. Plenty of things out there want to kill you. Others want to eat you.
I don't understand. Why would you want to help me? The North Grove has nothing to do with you.
I've got my own reasons for going.
Cotter! Now!
On the way! Please, don't tell anyone about me. The Watch would kill me if they found out.
Marine still smells like shit, even outside the walls.
We'll find Croft here, somewhere.
You alright?
Never better. Back under the Mad King, they used to say death by sword was a sweet kiss. But fire would fuck you hard.
Funny.
No. No, not very.
I'll go find Croft's tent.
Asher, I need you to tell me the truth. I've come a long way to bring you home. Back in that cave, you made a choice. You must have thought only one of us was going to survive. Now, it's not a fair question to ask, but I need to know. You don't even know, do you? Look, I can't blame you if your feelings about me are conflicted. Or your feelings about going home. Your family exiled you to this place. But I swore an oath to your mother, sailed halfway around the world to bring you back safe. And I'd be damned if some dragonfire or your foul decisions are going to stop me. Are we clear? I'm here to help you. To protect you.
Well, come on, Malcolm. Why are you making this such a big thing?
We're defined by the choices we make, Asher. One day, you'll understand that.
Asher, I know where Croft is.
This Croft, how well do you know him?
Too well.
I thought you said you were friends.
Yeah, we are. We are. Great friends.
Asher fucking Forrester. Son of a poxy whore. You have some balls walking into my tent after all these years with that mama's monkey grin on your face.
Well, that went well. Great friends indeed.
That's it. You're losing your edge, Croft.
You know you're right. I should kill you. Good fucking advice.
Whoa, no. I wasn't actually suggesting.
You never understood consequences, Asher. One stupid mistake cost me an eye. But you never learn. You figured you'd steal from me and I'd just forgive you? Not a fucking chance. So how are you going to pay me back? Your eye? Your hand? Or how about your tongue?
Croft, no!
Be reasonable!
I am reasonable! I'm letting him fucking choose! Well, you clearly don't need your fucking tongue.
Croft, I deserve your anger as much as Asher.
Don't worry, Beska. You're next. Now choose, or I slice off your balls, Asher.
Hey!
A man betrays my trust.
Fuck you, Croft!
Have it your way. You didn't need your testicles anyway.
Oh, that was bloody beautiful. Fucking Asher. You were pale as a snow bear's ass.
Are you fucking joking? You bloody bastard.
This is why people steal your shit and take off in the night.
Come on, you assholes. Have a drink.
Jodan, the Khaleesi's best wine.
Your friend has an interesting sense of humor.
So what in seven hells are you two doing here on the arse end of the earth, eh?
You're a long way from, young guy.
We have a proposition for you.
We? You're hardly the usual rabble these two travel with.
We need an army, Croft. My home back in Westeros is under siege.
We need your hellhounds. 100 good men.
Am I in a hobby's tip? Would I ever go back to Westeros?
I've got it good right here. Her grace pays good coin. I've got wine! Women!
Did this Khaleesi make you a house cat, Croft? Curled up at her feet? Since when do you turn down an adventure?
Since the second son swore to Daenerys bloody Targaryen. I've laid my sword at her feet, Asher.
Perhaps we could talk to her.
She's a little busy right now, commanding a fucking siege. Her enemies are nailing children up on posts for 100 miles, and a bloody dragon's gone missing.
But I know where to find her dragon.
Ha!
unfucking likely. You expect me to believe you've just happened to have seen the one fucking dragon loose in the world? Impossible.
Orange eyes, as big as my head. Scales all black.
That doesn't prove anything. Enough of this nonsense. We're done here, Asher.
I've got proof, you old fuck. Tell me what this is, if not a bloody dragon tooth.
I wouldn't know a dragon tooth from a basilisk dick.
Croft.
I've seen her dragon.
Oh, bugger me with a bloody spear. If you're lying about this, it'll cost more than your balls.
Fair enough.
Come on, you son of a bitch. The beast's name is Drogon. She'll want to hear about him right away. And don't think you're going to charm her with that fucking Asher grin.
Big day tomorrow, isn't it? Off to Craster's Keep. Assuming you're not too busy looking for your North Grove.
I thought you didn't believe in it.
Not saying I do.
But if it was real, can you trust Cotter with it?
You ask me. There's just something off about him. Aside from him being an oily thief, I mean. Like he's holding something back.
Wouldn't hurt to keep an eye on him.
Don't need to tell me that. He steals my knife, then your stuff. I'm not sure I want him walking behind me while we're out there.
Finn, get back on watch until your relief arrives.
They're late.
You think Mance Rayder is going to wait for them?
Right.
Asshole.
And Tuttle, you've got torches that have gone out. Keep them lit. Let the wildlings know we're still home.
Yeah, this one's still good. Need to light this torch. If anyone tries coming over the wall, well, those will stop them. That's ironwood for sure. Oh, a man could freeze to death up here. Uncle Duncan brought these from Ironrath. Wonder if I'll ever see it again. Solid ice. This won't be melting anytime soon. This must hold up the lift. Probably fall apart.
pig farmer. A 300-mile walk, and you're still in my way. I figured we'd settled things on the way to Crastus, but this is even better.
Oh, fuck you, Britt.
Still have some fighting spirit left in you, huh? I did duty to my lord back on that bloody farm. And for doing a proper job of it, what'd I get? Banished to the fucking wall! I never did tell you about your father, did I? We bled him at first, like a pig. Seemed only fair he should feel what it's like. Near the end, he could barely breathe. Kept begging us to leave your sister alone, so I made sure he was still alive when she started screaming. It was the last thing your father ever heard. The more we sliced, the worse it got.
You fucking shit!
Temper, temper. Too bad your father didn't fight like that. Might still be alive. And I thought you were going to make this easy.
You want my blood? Well, come and get it!
That was pathetic. Let's see if you scream like... You got lucky, pig farmer. You're going to slaughter me, like my man back at your farm. At least let me have my sword. Keep it interesting. Or are you afraid?
Take your sword. When you die, you'll know you weren't good enough.
So noble, you fucking cunt. Finish it! Go on!
Don't piss yourself on the way down!
These people are all scared, my lord. The White Hills have driven them away from the Ironwood Forests.
Out of the way!
And now they come here, starving, looking for food. Food we don't have to spare. How can we support an army and reclaim our place in the north if we can't even feed a handful of peasants? Our backs are at the wall again, and this won't get better on its own.
No one has more fight in them than Asher. I'm sure he and Malcolm will find us the army we need.
We'd better hope we figure something out. With those White Hill bastards in our house, we must be wary.
Come on, you!
Let me go! You can't do this!
Good. You're here. Look. Look at this. Did you see what this girl did? She attacked my man like an animal.
Bloody bit me.
Yeah, now it's her turn. She's gonna get what she has coming to her. This won't go unpunished.
Let go of me.
I don't care if she's your sister.
You'll do no such thing. I won't allow it.
That's not for you to decide.
I saw him stealing from our kitchen, and I told him to stop. He laid his hands on me, so I bit him.
Bloody wench!
I was only doing what had to be done.
I warned you not to mistreat my men. Someone will have to answer for this. Do you hear me? Don't make this ugly.
Thieves have to be punished, so your man got what he deserved. He's lucky he didn't get any worse than that.
So you've given over your duties to this girl, then? Or can you not control your sister?
Don't listen to him, Roderick.
And if you can't rein her in, what about the rest of them? It's about time she saw a real lord again and learned proper discipline. They've all been missing that.
My sister, she made a mistake. That's all. She is but a child, and this arrangement tests us all. I'll make sure it doesn't happen again.
She's not the only one who's made mistakes. And the problem starts at the top, Roderick.
Watch your tongue, boy.
You yourself had the gall to strike one of my men. And that's the real problem with you foresters. You're too fucking proud. Always have been. It was bad enough when you were above us. And now it's even worse. Because you don't see how far you've fallen.
Still high enough to look down at you.
Now here's a brave and wise girl. A girl who knows how to speak the truth of things.
No. A girl who should know her station. That's how I like to see you, foresters. Oh, foolish Roderick. Now I'll have to put you in your place. You will learn some fucking humility. Or this won't be the last lesson I teach you, foresters!
Have you no honour? I'll run you through for that. I'll cut you down like straw men.
Take him, Roiland!
My bloody pleasure. I'll fucking kill you myself!
No. Make him watch this. I bet this makes you angry, eh? You probably want to get up and hit me. But we know how that would go, don't we? Now, are you going to be a good little forester? Learn your lesson and stay down?
Roderick!
I will not yield.
You bloody snot. Why don't you fucking get it?
Get up, Roderick.
Stay down, my lord.
Your brother Ethan didn't know his place either. Ramsay Snow taught him good. Talia here will meet the same end. Unless you're a good little forester, you learn your place and stay down. Some forester is gonna learn their lesson today.
Don't you dare! You stay down! Stay in the mud like a dog!
This is my place!
You fool!
My lord!
What?! Bloody cripple! Are you fucking deaf?
You! You'll never keep the foresters down!
Hold there! Or you're next!
Please, Lord Griff, not the arm! If you persist, Lord Roderick may lose it!
Now, stay down!
Tell me!
Will you be a good little forester? Oh, you can't. I command you!
You
should fear me.
I'm in charge here!
You know what they did to me at the Twins? Shred my face, put their swords through me, tried to smash my skull open. But they couldn't kill me.
And you're not the man to finish the job.
Don't think this is over, Roderick! You'll see! I will make you suffer for this! Trust in that!
My boy.
Careful, he's badly injured.
Roderick, you didn't let him do it. He couldn't keep you down.
You were brave, but there will be consequences, my son. We both know that.
You see that? Standing up to Griff has made him harsh. More severe. He could have killed you. But what you did, the strength you showed us. You looked like yourself again. It was good to see.
I just hope I didn't make things worse. I couldn't let him punish you.
I know you couldn't. And when you're better, things will be different. I asked Ethan not to change who he was. He promised he wouldn't, and look what happened. I now know that was childish of me. I'm ready to change now. I'm willing to do anything to help our family. I mean it, Roderick. I don't care what. I'll do it.
I am too.
Father used to say we Foresters are as tough as the Ironwood.
We are.
All of us. And I'm sure the others will do whatever it takes as well. What you did, provoking Griff, it hasn't taken our house to war just yet. But...
no one can know the future. Whatever tomorrow brings, Talia, Foresters will stand tall.
I did it. I can't believe it. What are you waiting for?
I can't.
What? After everything, we just...
I can't burn it.
The Khaleesi will see you now.
So, Asher Forrester, if you presume to speak of my dragons, choose your words carefully.
What have you done, Garrett? Frostfinger is calling for your head. Tell me Britt's death was an accident.
Mira, what are you doing?
Mira, just tell me what's going on. What are you hiding from me?
We are weak. We have no allies.
And Griff will make us pay for your defiance.
There's been a raven from Lord Whitehill. He's invited us to High Point.
Drogon wouldn't have attacked without reason.
By order of the Queen!
Fuck you and your Queen!
Deal with your friend.
Nothing ever stays in the past, Asher.
Carried.